Hi, everybody. Happy Friday. You are here with Julia Campbell, and I help nonprofits build their movements and engage their online communities using social media. I really appreciate you being here with me today. The topic is going to be the Facebook Local app, how nonprofits can use it. What is it? How does it work? How is it set up? And how can nonprofits best leverage it? Or why should nonprofits even pay attention to it at all? Why is it important? First off, I'd love to know where you're watching from. I'm in Boston, north of Boston. It is a nor'easter right now, which basically means it's a bomb cyclone, or there's a million different terms. I don't know. We might lose power. The windows might blow in. I don't know. It's pretty bad outside. Branches are coming down. It's definitely wet. So I hope it's not as wet and rainy and cold and miserable where you are. But I'd love to know where you're watching from. I'm also going to be monitoring the comments just to see if you have any questions regarding anything involving nonprofits and social media and Facebook, and we'll take some at the end. Of course, if you have questions around Facebook Local, just let me know. So welcome. So some intro to the Facebook Local app. It's definitely not new, but there is a reason why it has kind of come back into prominence and gotten some attention recently. So in November of last year, Facebook turned its standalone events app into the Local app. And what they want it to be a one-stop search engine, quote unquote, to browse all the cool things happening where you live and where you're traveling to. You can leave reviews, you can RSVP, you can see what your friends are doing. And sounds a little bit familiar, right? It sounds exactly like Yelp. So in Facebook's eternal quest for world domination and taking down every other app in the App Store, they're making a play for Yelp now and Foursquare, which I don't know if anyone still uses Foursquare. I used to use it. I loved it. I don't think anyone uses it anymore. But it's definitely making a play to be like Yelp because Facebook wants everything to stay within Facebook. So love it or leave it, you know, take it or toss it. So one thing that's important to know about Facebook Local is that it is a very neat and clean way to find out what's going on locally. So there's no clutter, there's no pictures of babies, there's no cat videos, there's no like complaining about politics, there's nothing from your ex-boyfriend on there. It's really all information about places locally. So you can either turn your location to where you live, or if you're traveling, you can set your location where you're traveling. It's also focused on recommendations from your friends and, you know, quote unquote, neat things happening around your town and locality. So why should nonprofits be paying attention to this? I've written and I've talked a lot about the recent changes to the Facebook newsfeed. And honestly, I have seen these changes. Facebook's a pretty dramatically different place. And if you've seen some in the comments, let me know. I do know that there is a lot more interaction or a lot more personal updates. I'm seeing more personal updates from friends, and I'm seeing less of those passive consumer videos. I'm seeing fewer memes. I'm seeing fewer news articles, fewer public publications, fewer public page posts. I'm definitely seeing that. And if you have seen your organic reach from your page drop, let me know, because it's, I'm taking kind of an unofficial survey. Hillary says, hi from Philly. Oh, Lindsay says, New York City pushing through the storm together. I didn't know that it was going to be in New York City, but oh man, it's really bad. Hey, Saskia, how are you? Glad you could join me. All right, great. Yeah, I really hope no one's getting any of the coastal flooding that we were talking about, but it's certainly possible. So the other reason that it's important to pay attention to Facebook's new push for local is their new mission statement, right, is to give people the power to build community and bring the world closer together. And I've written a lot about this. They want us not to bowl alone. And if anyone read that book, it's fantastic. Malcolm Gladwell. We don't want to be bowling alone. They want us to be interacting. They want us to be talking to our neighbors, going in real life, IRL, to see people, to experience things. They want us to be civically engaged. They want us to be going to participate in events for causes that we care about, and they're pushing that especially. So the advantage with the local app is, as I said, there's less clutter, but also it's really a place where you can stand out and really reach the people that are going to be interested in your events. This is only if you have, of course, local events, or if you have a brick and mortar place. If you don't have a brick and mortar office for your nonprofit, or if your nonprofit, you don't invite the public to your office, you can still use this app because you can list your fundraisers or any other public events that you have like you would normally do on Facebook. So really with Facebook's push to make local news and community events a priority, I do think that more and more people are going to start using this app, but also Facebook is going to start in the news feed putting prominence on community events and local events and cause related events. And I've already actually seen that. So if you have the Facebook app on your phone, which you can get it for Android or iOS, and you know, it's totally free, obviously, because they want you to get it. Local will connect to your Facebook account. So you do have to link it to your personal Facebook account because you can't RSVP to events as an organization. You have to RSVP or post an event as an individual. I mean, you can post an event from your page, but if you're looking up events on local, you have to have an individual personal profile on Facebook. So that's something that's important. So once it's synced, then of course it's going to know where you are. It's going to know who your friends are based on who they are on Facebook, and it's going to know some things that you're interested in. So, you know, it's really interesting, and I think it's going to be useful because if you're someone like me and you've been on Facebook for multiple years, I mean, over a decade, at least a decade, if not over a decade, I've been on Facebook. Facebook has a lot of information about me, and they know things that I'm interested in. I just went on the local app this morning, just playing with it, and it was already suggesting events to me that I hadn't heard of in my local area that I would be interested in, or that I would recommend to friends and invite friends to. So it knows the kinds of things I'm interested in and passionate about based on my past activity on Facebook, based on events and happenings that I've clicked on, that I've commented on, based on pages that I like, and so on. So it's collecting that data. It's serving it up to people to hopefully show them things that they'll be interested in. So the app is going to be divided when you first go in to three sections. One is the home screen. That's where you can search by topic, by keyword, by location. It's also going to show you a running list of events in your area, trending events, which, I mean, who really knows what trending means? I guess it means popular, or maybe a lot of people are talking about them, or a lot of people have RSVP'd. Trending events, and it's going to show you things that it thinks you might be interested in. It's going to show you things that your friends have RSVP'd to, and things that your, you know, events that your friends have created, your connections have created. Sasuke says, does it sync events from the main Facebook platform, or do you have to post separately? Yes, it syncs. It syncs everything from your Facebook account. So if you are an admin of a page, or if you're creating Facebook events from your business Facebook page, everything is going to sync to local. What they wanted to do is they wanted to just create a standalone app that would function like Yelp, where people could go to find events but not go and get kind of hung up down the Facebook rabbit hole where we're just, you know, kind of checking updates and stalking people. So they wanted to make it a standalone app. It remains to be seen how much is going to be used and the popularity of it. But everything that you put on the main Facebook platform is going to sync with this app. And of course, you can still check your events in the regular Facebook app. You can still do that. That's not going to change. But I would say the big draw of the events app is that you don't have those notifications, you don't have a news feed, and you can discover events more easily than you would in the normal Facebook app, if that makes any sense. And Jim says stalking people, LOL. You know, you just go down a rabbit hole and you look at people's profiles. I don't even know. Okay. So moving right along, I am looking to see about your questions. Jim says we have to download a separate local app. I mean, Yes, I would download it and see how it works, especially if you are an organization that focuses a lot on events and you want the public to come to your events, you want to promote your events, then download the local app, sync it with your Facebook, play around with it. And the second section in the app, it's a lot like Yelp, where you can find recommendations via map. You can look for, you know, Indian food or Thai food or sushi. You can look for coffee. You can look for pretty much anything that you want, live music, that kind of thing. You can filter your results by relevance, by popularity. That means, you know, how many people have clicked on it, how many people are going, by distance from you, and rating. So one thing that I've seen that I, you know, that's different from Yelp is there aren't as many ratings on the Facebook local app, but I do think that's going to change. So that's something else that you definitely want to pay attention to. If you are a museum or a historical society or a library, somewhere where people are physically coming to your building and leaving you reviews, you do, and ratings, you want to be paying attention to that on your Facebook page, because it looks like it's going to affect your standing in the local app. So you should be paying attention to that anyway, but just a note for optimization in the local app. So the third section is your calendar, which I really love, because what I like to do on Facebook, I just like to say interested to a lot of events. So I tend not to say going or not going. I say interested because I want to keep it on my radar. I want to remember. I want to look at my calendar. I want to see, you know, if I'm going. Obviously, if it's a ticketed event, then I need to, you know, get my butt in gear and buy a ticket. But if it's a free event, or if it's just an awareness event or someone invited me and I just want to make sure I know about it and it doesn't require an RSVP like a birthday party or something like that where they need a headcount, I just say interested. And then in the local app, you can go look at all your events that you've RSVP'd to, and there's a neat little button in the bottom right corner where you can add it to your calendar, which is so amazing. Because as far as I know, maybe it's just in the Android version of the Facebook app, when I RSVP for events, I can't easily add it to my Google Calendar. There's not an easy way to do it. But with the local app, you just press a button in the bottom right-hand corner, you add it to your calendar, it's all synced, it's amazing, I think it's great. So a couple of ways that I think nonprofits should be leveraging Facebook Local. Number one is to create official Facebook events anytime you have an event that you want the public to know about, even if it's a virtual event, even if you're doing a webinar or a Google Hangout or something where you're inviting the public and you want them to know. Virtual events are a little bit harder because obviously the local app would have a hard time finding them unless you put your location in. You do need to put a location on your events in order for them to be discoverable in the local app. That just makes sense, right? But if you have a fundraiser or any kind of public awareness, marketing, fundraising event, and you want to either sell tickets or you want people to invite their friends, you want people to know about it, you want people to discover it when they're in the app, just create Facebook events and make sure you have the keywords in there. Make sure you have a location. Make sure you have a cover photo on your event. Just make it the best it could be. Make sure that it looks great. Make sure that it makes sense. Run it past a few people. Make great events. The other thing is to make sure your Facebook page is up to date. Not all of us can add a location, but at the very least, you should be adding your town. You should absolutely be adding your city or town on your Facebook page, because Facebook Local and Facebook, they will promote your stuff to local people. So what I've been seeing is a lot of fundraisers, a lot of different posts, especially from nonprofit organizations, show up in my notifications, Facebook saying, the Danvers Art Association posted an event. They are local to you. Would you like to check it out? I haven't seen a post from the Danvers Art Association in years, like an official page post, but they created an event. Facebook thought, hey, Julia likes local arts events. She goes to them sometimes. She likes the Danvers Art Association. Maybe she'd like this event. They send me a notification. You know, who knows how and why they send certain notifications, but I think that it's going to be a turning point for nonprofits. I really do, especially with organic reach down and it getting increasingly harder to reach our audience. So, you know, it does remain to be seen if individuals are going to use this app. I think with the popularity of Yelp, with the fact that people are getting more civically engaged, they do want to be more engaged in their community, they want to engage locally. The people that don't, then you don't want to worry about those people anyway. The people that never want to leave their house and don't want to go to your fundraiser, don't worry about them. But this app is a very good way to reach and to draw in the people that will be interested, that are interested, that might not have heard of your organization, but are on the app and see that their friends are going, or they're interested in other events, or maybe they just live in your town. They want to know what's going on in your town. It is going to be a way to, you know, kind of reach some new people. So I hope that helps. I am going to create a one-page cheat sheet to go along with this. I just did not have time today that you can download. So keep an eye. Let me put a link to the Facebook group. And if you join the Facebook group, it's group/social media storytelling. That is completely free to join. It's all nonprofit professionals. Then I will post the link to the cheat sheet in that group once it's ready. Okay, so let's see. Lee says, hi from rural Bradford County. Lots of snow. Oh, man, so you're getting snow. Oh, of course, Jim, 82 and sunny in Fort Lauderdale. I know. Lisa's from D.C. That's so great. Okay. And Saskia, I'm so excited to see you on here. Okay, let's see. Pittsburgh, Sherry from Pittsburgh. So Lisa asks, if I have a personal Facebook account and my organization wants a presence on the Facebook local app, do I need or should I make a new Facebook account? How do I keep personal Facebook separate from my work? Well, your personal Facebook is your profile, and that's where people friend request you. So you have friends. And then your business, the nonprofit, needs to have a Facebook page, which is a business page, which has fans and followers. So they're completely different and they're used completely differently. So you can create a Facebook page at any time. I think you just go to facebook.com/pages or just Google how to create a business page. Totally free. You will link it to your personal account, but no one is going to see it. No one will know, but there needs to be a person. There needs to be an administrator. They need to know a human is running the page. But I would create a business page on Facebook, and then you can create all your Facebook events through that business page, through that nonprofit page. And that will, it'll have your nonprofit name. It will have your either your logo, your avatar, the information for your business, and it will be completely separate from your personal account. Okay. Hillary says, do they have to be posted as events? We post a lot of events in our regular feed with links back to our signup page. If you have an event with a physical location, you should be creating a Facebook event and you want RSVPs and you want people to come, because Facebook will not know that your link is an event, right? They'll just see it as an outside link. And as we know, Facebook doesn't necessarily play nicely with outside links because they want people to stay within their ecosystem. So as much as you can create within Facebook, I mean, of course you're going to post the link to your official signup page in your Facebook event, especially if it's ticketed. You can put a link to the ticketing, to the Eventbrite or whatever you use for ticketing. You can put that into the Facebook event. But in my experience, Facebook has been actively promoting Facebook events to me and to other people. But if it's just a link, they're not going to know it's an event and they're not going to give it as much weight, and not as many people are going to see it. Molly says, if we don't have a lot of local events, is this worth putting time into? No. If you don't have a place where you want the public to, you know, physically come, and if you do not have events, then Facebook local, I mean, I think it would be worth putting some time into optimizing your Facebook page, making sure your address is on there if it's a place where the public goes. But if you're like a domestic violence shelter, You don't want anyone to know where you are, and you don't ever have any kind of fundraisers or anything like that, then no, this would not be worth it for you. This is only if you have either a location or events that are public facing. Hillary says, as an organization, can we improve our chances of being seen? Much of our day-to-day work is serving local families. On Facebook, the short answer is probably no, because business pages, they're just being demoted. And Facebook is trying to go back to its roots when people talk with people. The only way that really works still is to have those personal ambassadors. So your board members, staff, you can create a social media ambassador campaign or group. Having people be posting about what you do and encouraging their friends to click on your page and to sign up for your events, that works because Facebook is much more likely to show me an event, or not even an event. Facebook is much more likely to show me an update from a person now than from a page. So, you know, people are still getting traction with their small Facebook communities, but it is going down. And really the best way still, and this has not really changed on Facebook, but the best way is to get those personal recommendations from people. And then also just being a go-to resource for people, giving people a reason to go to your Facebook page, giving people a reason to subscribe to your updates, being that go-to interesting, useful, helpful resource to people that they kind of can't live without. That works too. Okay. Yes, we have a Facebook page. Okay. Molly says, are there other ways to encourage giving through Facebook local aside from events? Well, Facebook is really pushing fundraisers and fundraising on Facebook. So if your page is raising money, Facebook is not going to look at that as fondly as if you have people raising money for you. So everything that I'm seeing, like in my newsfeed right now, in terms of nonprofits, I see so many of my friends, Facebook showing me their fundraising pages. My friends that are raising money for various causes, if I'm friends with them on Facebook, Facebook is sending me a notification. Facebook's also, and I wish I had an example. Hold on, I do have it in my most recent blog post. I have what I'm talking about. Facebook is actively encouraging me every time I log in, because they know I love nonprofits, right? Because Facebook has a clue about me. It's asking me to start a fundraiser or support a fundraiser every time I log in. So let me try to show you. Let's see. I'm gonna show, I'll do this. So this is my friend Lauren. She did a fundraiser for my brother's table. I'm trying to get it like this. There we go. And that is much more likely to show up in my feed because it's a fundraiser. It's just so easy. See my friend Gabrielle, my friend Robbie, add a donate button. It's always asking me to add a donate button to my posts. Julia, want to finish donating? These are notifications that I received in my newsfeed. You know, raise money when you need it. The second I log into Facebook, I'm always seeing these. Either raise money when you need it, want to create a fundraiser for a nonprofit. I really believe that Facebook is creating this huge push around fundraising because they're getting so much flack from researchers and scientists that say spending time on social media and on Facebook is bad for you and causes you to be depressed and anxious. So they're trying to push the good things about Facebook, like connecting locally with people, meaningful interactions, creating a fundraiser. So they are pushing this. You do have to sign up for, you do have to sign up for Facebook tools, which is if you go to donations.fb.com, I'll just go right here. And you have to register to sign up for their tools. But once you do that, you're in their system, and every time you create a fundraiser, to raise money on Facebook, they're going to be pushing it out a lot more than your regular stuff. So, and Laura says, it stinks though, because they're late in getting a check. Well, that's, you're probably not signed up with Facebook payments, because if you're officially registered with Facebook, they transfer it directly to your bank account. But if you're not registered officially as a 501c3 and they don't have your information, then it takes about 45 days to get the check. That is right. So I would look into becoming an official registrant at donations.fb. You just have to send them your IRS letter and things like that, because then you get your funds much faster. All right. Well, I went a little bit longer. I usually only like to take 15 minutes, so we took about 25. If you have any more questions or comments, please let me know. And I would be happy, you know, I'll be happy to take them afterwards. Let me see. And I will post a link to the Facebook group. I'll post a link to the cheat sheet in the comments afterwards. I'm happy to do that. And let me just see what else I have. And I hope that you have a great day. Stay dry. Don't, you know, try not to go out in this horrible storm unless you have to. Be safe wherever you are. Jim, enjoy the 82 degrees like you're always doing. And just have a fantastic Friday, everybody. Thank you so much.